It's time for me to start on my next project. I'm going to be adding multi-material handling capabilities to my Voron 2.4. And to do this, I'm going to use the 3D Chameleon. There are a lot of options for MMU units. In the Voron community, a lot of people are using the Enraged Rabbit Carrot Feeder, or ERCF. The Trad Rack is also getting very popular. There are some newer designs like the 8-Track and the Box Turtle. But what I like about the 3D Chameleon is it is very simple and it is very small. It's designed to be adaptable to any printer because it can run standalone. So let's take a look at what the system actually is, and then I'll talk about how I'm going to be adapting it over. This is the brains of the 3D Chameleon. It has a controller as well as two 2209 stepper drivers with a number of control ports available. The kit comes with this end stop board, which is designed to be mounted somewhere on your printer so that your tool head can contact it. And depending on the number of times your tool head triggers this switch, will tell the controller what you want the system to do. The guts of the system is this unit that comes pre-printed and assembled, which has two extruder motors. The filament will go in this side. In these four holes, the unit will do up to four colors standard. This unit has an eccentric gear that moves these bars back and forth that select which one of these PTFE output tubes is being driven by this motor. So there's a drive gear here and there are bearings in there. So those bearings will slide back and forth to determine which one of the filament paths is engaged by the drive motor. And then the filament comes out of the selector through these PTFE tubes into a 4-into-1 mixer. So you've got a very compact system. You have this motor that I would refer to as the feeder, which just exists to load and unload the filament until it gets to your printer's extruder. And then this motor, which goes and selects which one of those paths it's actually driving. So this is designed, as I said, to be sort of universal. You can adapt it over to any printer. The designer normally recommends that this combiner be mounted at the tool head to limit the length of the retractions. But this doesn't work very well in my head with my Voron. Number one, I don't want to have to pass four pieces of PTFE through the back panel. I'm also not thrilled with the amount of drag that that would cause, as well as all of this hanging off the top of the tool head. I can see this causing some resonance issues and just generally not being great. So my first sort of departure from the recommended installation is I'm planning on having this on the outside of the frame so that I still only have one piece of PTFE going to the tool head. The other thing I have to deal with is this switch. While this would be fine on an open frame printer, my V2 is enclosed, so that means I've got even more wiring and stuff that I have to run into the build volume. The other consideration for me is that my V2 is, of course, a flying gantry. So this would have to somehow be mounted onto the gantry so that my tool head would be able to come over and contact it, as well as the consideration then of how do I get this wire to the gantry. I use a can tool head. My system has an umbilical. There are no cable chains, and I'm certainly not going to install cable chains just to run this switch. So I'm going to try and solve this problem by not using this switch and instead using a package called 3D Chameleon Clipper by a user named 3D Coded. This not only replaces the switch by wiring directly from the Raspberry Pi that's running Clipper into the 3D Chameleon control board, but it also adds macros and touchscreen control through Clipper screen that'll let me be able to manage this whole system directly from my printer. So the first step to getting this up and running is to upgrade the bootloader on the board so that it'll run at a faster speed and then flash it with the Mark IV Pro firmware. To upgrade the bootloader, I grabbed my trusty Arduino Uno clone that I've had for many years for just this type of purpose. So I plugged it into my computer via USB, opened the Arduino software, uploaded the Arduino ISP sketch from the examples, then restarted the board so that that firmware would be loaded. I used the wiring instructions from Chris's Basement, who has previously done some videos about the 3D Chameleon. I'll link to that information in the description of this video. Once that was wired, I used the Arduino software to upload the bootloader. Once that was done, I had to install the AVRDude software using Brew because I'm on a Macintosh. Once I had Brew installed, then I was able to confirm the bootloader was properly loaded and was able to upload the firmware. So one of the benefits of the Mark IV Pro firmware is the ability to do hardware add-ons. As of this video, there are two that are available. One is an OLED screen so that you can see what the 3D Chameleon is going to be doing. The other is an automated filament cutter that is servo driven. I don't think I'm going to use one of those because it's, again, too much stuff to put on the tool head for my taste, but let me get the screen hooked up and I will turn the system on and show you what it looks like. So I should mention that the kit comes with a 12 volt wall wart power supply, which I'm probably going to replace with a buck converter so that I can just power from my 24 volt power supply in the V2. It also comes with an assortment of PTFE tube and couplers and everything that you will probably need to be able to adapt this over to your printer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to power up the board. It's in its ready mode. And by holding down the switch, it will go to different functions. So now it thinks it's going to load 0. And it's idle. If I say switch to 2, it would cut. Now, if I hold the switch again, it's unloading. And now we would load. And let me bring this up so you can see what's going on here. Gorf, heavy. So let's say I'm going to switch to 1. The cam moves. Now that would be unloading 2. It moves the cam to position 1. And then that would be loading. And then the system is idle. So as you can see, there's a lot of functionality in not a lot of space. Again, one of the reasons why I was interested in this system in the first place is that you don't have 4 separate extruders driving everything. You just have 1 selector motor and then 1 motor to drive the filament to the extruder on your tool head. So my next challenges are I have to get the buck converter sourced so that I can power this. I also have to wire the Raspberry Pi into the control board. I've got to mount the control board somewhere and probably just try and finish up the rest of the physical installation and get ready to do the software integration. So that's where I am right now with this project. And I will be bringing you the next part, hopefully soon, where we get to see how this all wound up on the printer. Thanks for watching.